안녕하세요. 박정철입니다.
Hello, I'm Dr. Park Jong-chul. When it comes to the implant surgery, understanding anatomy is very important. We need to understand the morphology of the surgical area to conduct appropriate surgery, and we need to understand where blood vessels and nerves are running to avoid the risk during surgery and to minimize the side effects. So we need to understand each structure and morphology of that more than anything else. In this lecture, we are going to talk about anatomic considerations for implant placement. First, the mandible. Today, we are going to talk about anatomic mandible, primarily three things. First, when we do the implant surgery, we need to be careful when it comes to the mandible morphology. Second, blood supply of mandible. Three, sensory nerve of mandible. After that, I'm going to summarize briefly what was discussed. First, let's have a look at the mandible morphology. If you look at a face, the bone at the bottom of the face is mandible. The bone is thicker than maxilla, so mandible has dense compact bone, which is a favorable environment for placing implant. This is not always the case, but when we place the implant, the angulation of the implant is similar to natural teeth. Therefore, we need to understand the direction and angulation of teeth. In the mandible, all teeth in the mandible are inclined to the mesial side, so that forms a natural speed curve, curve of speed. Therefore, when you place an implant, like in the left, the inclination should be similar to the natural teeth of mandible, so it should be mesially inclined. It is in line with the direction of the masticatory muscle contraction. From the mechanical perspective, a mandible implant should be placed with mesial inclination. On the right, the distally inclined implant may damage the mesial tooth root. And also, from the mechanical perspective, there is a danger or risk of abutment or screw fracture. Therefore, when implant is placed on the mandible, it should be mesially inclined. If you look at the buccolingual inclination of lower natural teeth, the anterior teeth are a bit buccally inclined, but all posterior teeth are slightly lingually inclined, forming natural curve of Wilson. So when you place an implant at lower molar area, like in the right, the buccally inclined implant is not good for the opposing teeth and also mechanical masticatory perspectives. So when you place an implant, there is a risk of lower lingual perforation. You need to be careful. However, when the alveolar ridge is severely resorbed, sometimes it is difficult to incline the implant lingually. When there are teeth in a normal case, maxilla covers the mandible, class 1 relation. The mandible is mesially inclined, and the functional cusp of lower teeth go into the central fossa of the upper teeth. However, when a lower tooth is extracted and the ridge is horizontally resorbed, and the implant is placed considering the resorbed bone, the implant will tend to incline lingually too much. In this case, the lingual inclination angle should be reduced to place the implant more vertically. Then the fabrication of prosthesis can be made easy. For an implant placement angle, pre-op diagnosis, surgeon's experience and judgment are very important. Recently, digital-guided surgery became available. If you use it, implant positioning can be made good. However, if you place an implant with less lingual inclination on the lower lingual side, there are sublingual, submandibular glands in this fossa. When you place an implant, you need to be very careful not to perforate this area. Another structure that you need to be careful in the mandible is the inferior alveolar canal and the mental foramen. Before surgery, we need to identify the locations of these on the X-ray. So when you place an implant, you need to be careful not to touch them because nerve and the blood vessels are running there. Next, blood supply of mandible. The blood supply comes from the heart, so jawbone blood is supplied from below, from external carotid artery branches the maxillary artery, from there branches the inferior alveolar artery, which goes through the mandibular foramen and into the inferior alveolar canal. From mental foramen, mental artery comes out. The incisive artery runs in the anterior region to supply blood. Blood supply of mandible, external carotid artery, from there, maxillary artery. From here, there are three parts. From mandibular part, inferior alveolar artery comes out. From there, mental and incisive arteries are branched. Three main vascularization characteristics. First, blood is supplied from posterior to anterior. The blood comes from the heart from posterior region to the anterior region. Blood is running. Second, the vessels run parallel to the alveolar ridge. Three, they run parallel like this, therefore the edentulous alveolar ridge is covered by a 1 to 2 millimeter wide vascular area. As you have seen, the three main vascularization characteristics is very important in designing the incision for implant placement. The details will be covered in the flap design lecture. Regarding the vessels, we need to be careful. Mandibular lingual concavity. In the lingual side of the mandible, as discussed before, submandibular gland and sublingual gland run in this fossa. Implant is placed very well in C. However, if they are placed in A or B, in the case of B, it is too buccally inclined, then perforation can be occurring in the lingual side. If submandibular fossa is severe, if you place a long implant like this, it can end up like a perforation. The perforation like this can occur. In this case, we need to be careful not to make the perforation by using short implants. When you make a perforation, drilling can damage blood vessels running below, which can result in severe bleeding. So you need to be careful. Next, sensory nerve of mandible. In the dentistry, nerves are primarily from the trigeminal ganglion, and the ophthalmic nerve goes to the eyes, and the maxillary nerve goes to the maxilla, and the mandibular nerve is branched from there to go to mandible. The mandibular nerve is branched into six nerves, and we need to be careful when we place an implant. Long buccal nerve and the lingual nerve, inferior alveolar nerve. And the inferior alveolar nerve goes through the mandibular foramen to mandible. It becomes the inferior alveolar nerve that controls the sensation of the mandible. The nerve from the mandibular foramen is divided into mental nerve and incisive nerve. The mental nerve comes from the foramen and controls the sensation of lower lip. The mental foramen location is very important because it can be damaged during implant placement. Therefore, mental foramen location should be identified before surgery. In dentate mandible, It is located halfway between the alveolar ridge and the inferior border, generally below the roots of premolars. When there are teeth, mental foramen is located inferior to a premolar root in general. In edentulous case, if the location is not clearly shown on the X-ray, it can be confusing. In edentulous case, it is 1/4 of the mandibular symphysis to the posterior border of ramus. On the panorama X-ray, so on the panorama X-ray, it is 1/4 of the mandibular symphysis to the posterior border of ramus. The mental foramen has the anterior loop. According to Mish and Crawford, in 12% of the cases, the anterior loop is 3 mm high. According to the Arousman, in 90 to 96% of the cases, the anterior loop has 2 mm or longer. So when you place an implant in the anterior of a mental foramen, the anterior loop is 3 millimeters and the safe space of 2 millimeters should be secured. Therefore, an implant needs to be placed at least 5 millimeters away from foramen. This patient had implants placed at another clinic for overdenture and came to my junior alumni office complaining about the lip sensation problem. The junior called me saying the mental nerve seems to have been touched, and another dentist said there was no problem with the implants placed anterior to the mental foramen. If you trace what appears to be the mental nerve and the inferior alveolar nerve, it looks like the anterior loop of the mental foramen is touched. To double check, using the approach to find the mental foramen in edentulous ridge, the mental foramen is located at 1/4 of the mandibular symphysis to the posterior border of ramus, and the implant is close to the anterior loop and the mental nerve injury is suspected. Just avoiding the foramen is not good enough. The safe space of 5 millimeters from the foramen should be secured when placing an implant. Next case, releasing incision was made and the mental nerve was injured. After implant placement, bone graft is done to pull soft tissue. Releasing incision was made. Mental nerve was checked. So the incision was made avoiding that nerve, but sensation problem lasted 1.5 years. Therefore, when you place an implant in the mental nerve area, soft tissue needs to be handled with care. Inferior alveolar canal is bent under the third molar, 50% of the cases. In terms of distance to teeth, it is closest to the root of the second molar. Inferior alveolar nerve is running in the inferior alveolar canal. When the nerve is injured, it will become an incredibly hard problem, catastrophe. There are many reasons for the injury. The first reason, direct injury by drilling. Second, thrombosis over the nerve. The compression can cause the injury. Third, as implant is placed, the bone fragments can compress the nerve. Four, it is rare, but the site heals and the bone grows over the nerve, and the compression from the bone can cause the injury. I have been fortunate that I have not injured the nerve yet, but this is my senior doctor's case. At 46 and 47, implants were placed. At 46, if you look at the implant there, the inferior alveolar canal was invaded. It was removed immediately and placed again above it, but irreversible paresthesia occurred. So if you are a dentist who does the implant placement, whether you are skilled or a beginner, you always need to be careful when you work near nerves. Next, let's talk about the lingual nerve. The lingual nerve is the lingual branch of the mandibular nerve. It controls the sensation for mouth floor and two-thirds of the tongue. The lingual nerve comes from the mandibular nerve, and it runs closest to the alveolar ridge at the lingual side of the third molar, and as it goes further to anterior, it goes away from the ridge. It is close to the lingual side of the ridge and also horizontally runs close to it. Lingual nerve. Some people ask whether lingual nerve is in bone, but the nerve is always in soft tissue. It is very close to the alveolar ridge at the lingual side of the third molar. Therefore, it requires a great caution when you make a flap in the lingual side. The lingual nerve is found to be injured more often than the mental nerve, according to some reports, so you need to be very careful. The long buccal nerve is the buccal branch of mandibular nerve, and it controls the sensation for cheek, skin, and mucosa. To make a flap in the buccal mucosa, anesthesia is used for this nerve. Up to now, we have talked about the anatomy of mandible in relation to implant placement. I talked about the three main things. Let me briefly summarize what I have presented. First, mandibular form. Implant should be placed in the angulation similar to natural tooth angulation. Second, the blood supply of mandible, the characteristics of blood vessel in the mandible. Due to lingual form of the mandible, a perforation can occur, so we need to be careful not to make lingual perforation. Third, sensory nerve of mandible, incisive nerve, mental nerve, inferior alveolar nerve, and long buccal nerve. We need to be careful when we place implants about the nerves. We fed up with the anatomy classes in dental school, and how was it today? I believe understanding anatomy is understanding our body. That is the basis for successful implant placement. Through the experience, I believe the understanding will be enlarged and the successful outcome of implant surgery can be achieved. Even though this is a boring subject, I believe you need to understand the anatomy very well. I hope this lecture proves to be helpful for your successful implant surgery. Thank you very much. 고맙습니다.